Hello everybody, welcome to GBPT Pokemon Channel. I'm here with Adam.
Hey guys, how you doing?
And we've got a really special episode here for you today. We have some Phantom Forces we have to open. We've acquired these from an eBay seller. Seems pretty trusty so far. Let's hope they're not wide packs. But they shouldn't be. Let's have faith, let's have hope. We're going to do a random amount of arts, as we've been naughty and sneaked a few packs behind scenes, but there was nothing pulled special, so hopefully it's all in here. In the back you may notice, let me just get that out of shot a minute, we have the Japanese box, two of them, one of mine, one of Adam's. We've got the Evolutions XY break pack, that's the Japanese anniversary one, the CP2. What we're going to do right now is start on these bad boys. I'm just going to open them from the stack, I think, from the top right the way down to the bottom. So we're going to start off with the Diancie pack first, the Diancie art, looking very cool there. Let's get this going. Oh, these packs feel quite sturdy, quite heavy. I don't know if it's just because it's the first card and there's something magic in it.
I hope so, man. There's a lot of really awesome cards in this set, and you might see a recurring art style in the background images.
Yes, right. Kick things off with Lightbard.
Shadow.
We're going to reveal names first, but we'll go from the bottom. Trick Coin. Sliggoo. Swirlix, Finneon, Gligar, Joltik, Yanma. Ooh, nice. Cool art, man. Reverse Lipard. And in the back for our first pack, we have a Machina. Cool art. Yeah, I'm going to take it pretty slow on the first viewings that we see of each art, and then speed it up, get it going quicker and quicker. Try not to be naughty like Adam, reveal every pack before we see it all.
I can't contain my hype. I'm trying not to look when you open them so I don't get
a reaction or a giggle. Right, we've got a Versus Seeker, which is necessary for the decks. Giraffe Rig, cool art though. Dimension Valley.
Now that art, the bubbles, the colourful bubbles, that's going to be seen in quite a few artworks in this set, which I think is really cool.
It's recurring in Phantom Forces, yeah?
Yeah.
Karrablast. Joltik with trainers in the background. Pumpkaboo. So Team Rocket and Astid. Rock and Roller. Fletchling. Cute art. Nice, we have a reverse. This rare Spiritomb. I think they consider him a legend. And in the back, a Venomoth, regular rare.
Now, if you look at these two arts, both of them have those bubbles in the back.
Oh, yeah.
So that we've already got two, well, three in fact, because of the other card that started with.
So it's a recurring art throughout them?
Yeah. And it's one of the only packs that I've really been able to notice so much consistency. Let us know if you notice any others in the other packs, guys.
Brilliant. Awesome. Awesome, Ad. You'll give us all sorts of wicked information like that, Adwell. Monster of poker knowledge. Right. Another Diancie pack right here. I know this might seem a bit weird. We're doing all of one art at a time, but I can't be bothered to organise packs because I'll be there forever. 1, 2, 3 from the back. And if you stick around and watch the rest of the video, you might see a code card at the end. Just as a bit of enticement for you. So we have Lipard. Trick Coin. Sliggoo. Murkrow. Swirlix. Finneon, I've seen that in other packs of their openings. The Gligar. The Jolteon. Ooh, reverse Alamomola. That's the way you say it, which I think's got something to do with the new regions. And what we got? Oh, it's shiny! It's shiny! Gengar EX! Oh, my bad, man!
Which pack was this, man? Third?
Third pack? Oh, code cards. Third pack. And we have ourselves beautiful Gengar EX.
And now, that's what we're talking about there. See how...
the recurring bubbles.
Yeah, it's on the Mega Gengar EX as well.
Oh.
So I feel we're going to pull.
I really hope so. Ad, would you mind just leaving that and dropping it in the back, back, dude?
Yeah, put it right in there.
Well, this pack's being a bit of a...
These are pretty tight.
Yeah, very tight. Those are the gold ones that came out of presentation pack. Oh, let's get those. I'm not sure. Two, three for me. It doesn't. I think these newer Ultra Pro sleeves, I've got a feeling they're a bit smaller.
Yeah.
Than the ones we used to buy. Yeah, so we can't double sleeve with it. The older type you can. Like the target whistle. Handscope. Swadloon. Carablast. Skarmory with Wicked Art. Pumpkaboo. Hey, cool. Now, mate, Chansey. Mashana. No, sorry, Munna. Apologies. Hey, reverse Loudred. Looking wicked. And behind him, we have a Galvantula. Regular rare. Let's get this moving a bit quicker. I think, don't hold me to it, but I think I spoilt that for myself. And maybe you guys then, maybe not. Oh, shut up. So we have, to start things, Lampent. AZ. Hey, Wicked, been looking for one of these for a deck. Special Psychic Energy. Skarmory. Rock and Roller. Frillish. Venonat. Looks cool. Ooh, Chansey in a second pack. A reverse Finneon. Love the blue reflection. And in the back, another pack. What have we got? Aegislash EX.
Oh, that's awesome, dude.
Or Aegislash EX, however you want to pronounce it, guys. This is a beautiful card.
It is so awesome.
I think this proves that they may not be weighed. So that's always a bonus.
Wasn't there something about code cards being different weight? So to reduce the scale?
Yeah, I watched a guy on YouTube called Melvin the Nerd. You may have seen him, you may not. He does his little adventure in America. He goes to Target or Walmart and he goes and weighs packs, and a random lady comes along and says, you do know that there's different weighted code cards, don't you know? So you may not necessarily have an EX in the pack. It was just a random woman that was walking past, so that's where I heard that theory. I don't know how true it is, guys, but it might very well be the case. So kick it off with Shauna, mate. Trick Coin, Target Whistle, Litwick, Wicked Art, Swirlix, seems quite recurrent, Helioptile, awesome man, Zubat, our man, our best mate in Pokemon Go, not, well he is when Crobat comes in, Whismur, another reverse Finneon, and a Diggersby regular rare in the back. Awesome. Next packet we have One, two, three. You can see that they're centering off just by the backing of some of these cards. So we have our Baldur. Loudred. Ooh, who's that guy? Zerosic. Zerosic? Exerosic?
I just beat him in the next.
How have you? In the 3DS gameplay?
Mm-hmm.
Brilliant. Before, oh yeah, of course. Yes, yes, yes. Swirlix. Finneon. Gligar. Ooh. Ooh, we've got our Spirit Link and he's a holo as well. Behind that, we got ourselves a Mighty Anna. Regular.
This Gengar Spirit Link is just a hint that Mega Gengar is coming out of these packs.
And guess who's next as well? Gengar himself. So guys, I've had an idea with all the code cards. I might save them until I get 250 of them and do a live stream of 250 opening. I don't know if this is going to be on our new Twitch account or whether we're going to do it for YouTube, which I think we should do it for YouTube to test things out. But yeah, if you think that's something that you'd be interested in, let us know. So we've got Lipard, Trick Coin, Sligo, Venona, Murkrow, Helioptile, Spearow, Yanma, hey, cool, Reverse Skarmory. Behind him, no way!
Oh.
Lysander's trump card, full art. Oh my goodness.
That looks awesome, dude.
That is a beautiful looking card, 118 out of 119. So it's the second from last in the set. I'm gonna hand that over to you, dude. Now this card is banned in TCGO. Did you know that?
Yeah, I've heard it before.
It's a bit of a naughty card, to be honest.
Yeah, you can see why it's banned. I like the fact that it sort of reflects the personality of the game.
Yeah, definitely. Because of the current XYZ episodes, I'm watching, currently watching subbed episodes, Japanese episodes, and I can't tell whether he's got more of an evil side or more of a good side. Is he leading Ash on at the moment, or is it, I think it's Alan, who's his understudy, who does a lot of the Mega Evolution battles. So yeah, I can't tell whether he's good or bad. Here we have Furfru. Firo. Hey, Lysander's trump card. Joltik. Pumpkaboo. Rock'n'Roller. Fletchling. Munna. Hey, that's cool. Reverse Giraffe Rig. And behind, no way, Florges EX full art.
This
dude,
is awesome,
these packets, man.
Great card.
Oh my goodness.
Thanks, eBay.
Yeah, thank you very much, eBay. And this guy's 116 out of 119. Very nice, man. We're really going to appreciate these cards in the collection after. And we'll find out who the eBay seller is, because definitely he's getting credit for this.
The description in the video, it's going to be linked to his eBay profile.
Okay, yeah, Ad's got a better thought process than me when it comes to production.
Sometimes.
Well, don't be modest. So we have another special energy, which is brilliant for the decks. Fletchinder, it's our first one. Steel Shelter, first one. Skarmory, Karrablast, Fletchling, Bunnelby, Zubat. Oh yes, Legend, Reverse Holo Heatran. And behind him we have a regular Air Diggersby. All right, the hype's dropped back down for a packet. Is this up and coming to magicness?
I quite like these still reverse hollows in this set. They're really nice.
I just love the fact that new cards have a hollow in every single packet. You know, whether it's an uncommon or a common. or a rare. Things. Yeah, it's nice because you've got guaranteed nice cards. I appreciate everything I pull out of these, to be honest. Conjurer. We've got ourselves Trick Coin. Burfru. Hey, Swadloon. I've seen that in other XY art. Can't think what. Purloin. Swaddle. Wisma. Zubat again. Helioptile. Ad's getting a bit of a reaction here so you can see better from the side. Litleo reverse. And behind, we've got a Malamari X full art. Holy moly.
That looks awesome.
Oh, I've got no words. All right, let's have a closer look at it. Wow.
Such a beast of a Pokemon as well. Oh.
I've never used him in the video games or TCGO.
I battled against it and I didn't have the correct team setup and it just ruined me. And it's so like dumb.
Malamar.
So big and evil.
Well, you don't think about that when in its pre-evolution of Inkay, do you? He seems ever so harmless. But it's a Team Rocket Pokemon, so again, I'm not a fan on evil Pokemon. Right, we have Robo Substitute. Yes, more Tiernos. We need these to build decks. We have Croconaw. Frillish. Male and female in that shot. Venonat. Chansey. Punkaboo, Goomy, lovely, reverse or just a holo item, Seeker, and in the back we have a regular rare Bronzong, statue Pokemon, is he?
One of the meta of VGC 2016, quite a few people used it.
The Bronzong?
Yeah.
Is that what I saw a clip of Wolfie playing?
Again. Wolfie was playing against
a Bronzong.
Yeah, and he won. And I just love that Raichu on this thing.
Yeah, you mentioned it the other day about the battle, and I put it on last night. I sort of fell asleep watching it because it was so late after recording. So I'm going to catch that video copy. Dimension Valley, Stadium Card, AZ, Fletchinder, Goomy, Litleo, Finneon. Venonat, Murkrow, nice grass, Karrablast, reverse, and in the back, Holo Pyrol, looking ever so fiery, protecting his little ones, I'm guessing, because I noticed he's like that in the anime. They push the young males out to teach them to look after their own.
Just a quick mention. If you look at the Dimension Valley card, that also has those little balls in the background.
Oh yeah, the bubbles.
Yeah.
Like floating candies.
Yeah, jelly babies.
Jelly babies, yeah. Right, we've got an Aegislash art. I think we've got through all the Gengars now. Can we do clean sweeps like that every time? Probably not. 1, 2, 3 from the back. I always put them straight to the front, it's just less messing about. Everybody's got their own system. Croconaw. Tierno. Robo Substitute. Alamomola. Visma. Swirlix dancing in jelly babies. Poochyena. Yanma. Reverse Bronzor went in the back. We have a Jelly Scent, which is brand new, going in the set. Regular rare. Aegislash. Find these episodes easier when there's a second person around. Feels more organised. And a bit more easier to do the recordings, as we can tell you a bit more information, because I'm not overly great on Pokemon knowledge. Well, these I believe are needed. Oh, I'm ever so sorry.
I don't know if I saw something there or not, but
I was
playing games on myself.
Battle Compressor. Yee, another Psychic special. Lampent. Pumpkaboo. There's a Chandelure in this set, isn't there? I think. So, yeah. Spearow, Mudlock, Chandelure, Gullpin. Yay, Totodile, little cutie. Yammer. All the dark reverses, I really like them. Just a Purloin. And behind that, we have a Moshana. Regular bear. Yeah, that was your eyes playing tricks on you.
The Purloin. Because I saw the dark ones, yeah, it's quite like an EX card.
Yeah. Do love the graphic of it. Right, next packet. Three from the back, and we flip. We have a Versus Seeker. Again, good for the decks. Girafarig. Dimension Valley. Fletchling. Bunnelby. Zubat. Murkrow. Swirlix. Lumineon Reverse, which is a new one. And in the back, Gliscor. He was a monster with Toxic Orb on a competitive VGC. I need to start learning how to use him. Can you teach him Earthquake?
I don't know this one, to be honest with you. But since it's fighting, possibly. I don't know the type in the game, to be honest. I've only really seen a few VGCs.
Okay, so you're more of a specialist at cards then, to be honest. And obviously the older games as well. You know quite a lot of that stuff. So Loudred. Ooh, ooh, Manectric Spirit Link, that's a first one. Dimension Valley. Karrablast. Helioptile. Purloin. That's a first as well, Dedenne. As a fairy type in this set. Joltik. Oh wow, that's awesome. Another legend, Deancey Reverse. And in the back, we have... Hey, Chandelure, man. Hollow. That's the one I was looking for. He's in my team.
He's a monster. Hasn't he got the highest special attack in the whole game?
It's either between him or one of the legends. I can't think who I use. Who's a special attacking sweeper, who's a monster. He's higher than output than Gengar, higher output than Alakazam. I think so. I run him with a Choice Scarf, and you can hit first and swap in and out. Use him as a luck Pokemon. So we've got Girafarig, Target Whistle, Lampent, Finial, Fletchling, Munna. Bronzor, Purloin. I think that's the second reverse Purloin.
Yeah, indeed.
And in the back, another Jellicent. Well, we're coming to the end of the Aegis slash Arts. A little bit sticky to get open these. 1, 2, 3. Loudred, Roller Skates, Fletchling, Purloin, Swaddle, Wisma, Zubat, Helioptile, cool, Hollow, Steel Shelter, and behind that, oh my god, the Team Flare card! What?
Awesome, I love the red on that, holy cow.
That's a beauty of a card, man. Hypergear. Pokemon Tool F. Attach this Pokemon Tool to one of your opponent's Pokemon EX that doesn't already have a Pokemon Tool attached to it. And it increases the retreat cost of that Pokemon. That could be quite a handy card, you know. I don't know what sort of meta or if it's banned or anything like that, but that is a gorgeous card, don't you agree, Ad?
Oh,
I've never seen a red border.
No, I've never seen one either. I saw the set list online for this, and I saw this and it was just red, you know, so I didn't really think it would be this amazing, but that looks awesome, man.
Is this also the one that is in the Japanese set, by any chance?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Oh, I might as well that card, I really am. Okay, I'm going to pass it on and open another pack. I don't think we need to after those. Right, last Aegis Slash Art. One, two, three, four, five. Oh, what the hell am I doing here? One, two, three. I'm a bit enticed by that last card, man. It's shook me. Right, we have Shauna. Battle Compressor. Yes. Yes, yes. Special Psychic Energy. Dino. Karrablast. Helioptile. Purloin. Dedenne. Hollow. Lysander's Trump card. So we've got every one now for the collection. And behind that, a Pachisaru. He's a rare. Cool. Seen quite a few electric types in this compared to other XY sets. Awesome, man. Right. Mega Main Extra Cards. I'll put one of these away as well. One of the packets for a rainy day. We've had quite a calm, haven't we, after that storm? After the first wild part. Three from the back. Try not to get a reaction out of Ad. Flip them. So we've got Enhanced Hammer. These are good to use in your deck. Same as Shauna. Wobbuffet. Did I know? Litwick. Frillish. Helioptile. Purloin. Another reverse Bronzor. And behind, Honchkrow. Regular air, he's new. He'll be in the binder as well. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven packs left. See if we can at least get a Mega Gengar EX out of these as well.
If that happens, I will be very happy.
Was this the set with the Giratina in as well? I haven't really done my research on these sets of cards yet. We do use Pokélector, it's just these are the first Phantom Forces for the channel. Gengar Spirit Link. Croconaw. Klefki, who's steel type in this set. Alamomola. Skarmory. Roggenroller. Frillish. Venonat. Reverse Swirlix. Brand spanking new, and another Holo Pyro. We don't moan at that though. Would be something for a deck. There you go, Coinsert.
No Holo duplicate is ever bad.
No. Can always be used or swapped into a good home. One, two, three. The front. No sneaky peekies. So we have ourselves another Croconaw. Lipard. Trick Coin. Fletchlim. Munna. Goomy. Litleo. Sneaky little face. Finneon. A hollow Trick Coin. And behind that, hey! The holo version of the Heatran from earlier. Wicked. He used to be one of my favourites on the game as well. He's an awesome legendary.
Mm. He's pretty competitively viable as well.
Still up to this day.
Yeah.
Under two. To the front. And we have ourselves a brand spanking new Golbat, Lumineon, Zuelas, I think that's the first one I've pulled, Gligar, Joltik, Yanma, Gulpimp, Spearow, Reverse Venonat, and behind him we have a first, which is Gliscor. Or did I pull that before? No, I mentioned Gligar earlier, but yeah, come on. Regular rep. Still soldering through these main extra cards. Oh yeah, some of them are boss.
Now three left. Well, this four including this one. I know the pain of some. Sometimes you just get one pack that's a nightmare for everything.
Yeah, and you have to end up destroying it. 1, 2, 3. Now, if you stick around for the rest of the video, you'll get yourselves a code card out of each of the rest of the packs. So we have a Croconaw, Nidorino, Trick Coin, Gulpin, Spearow, Munnet, Venonat, Purloin, Shiny Shauna. We always get a Shiny Shauna. Behind her, we have Mighty Enna. Bad Pooch. Being so dark.
Almost every team fan member has it from their team.
Oh yeah. They don't mess about, do they? Well, there's the first code for you guys. 1, 2, 3. What can these last three packs bring us? We haven't had a lot in the last few. So Baldur thinks no. Conscope, Croconaw, Rock and Roll It, Carablast, Dino, Bronzor, Krabby, a Reverse Spearow, and a Escavalier in the back. Regular rare. Cure.
I believe, man, these last two packs, at least one of them.
Come on, special shakes.
If you could be kind enough to only use up one code to leave for the viewers, that would be much appreciated.
Yes, please. One per user. So we can get as many as we can out there to you. So there's your second card. 1, 2, 3. We start it off with Xerosic. Please correct me if I'm wrong with that.
I don't know, man.
Sligo. Oh, come on. Let's see a Manectric in the back. Manectric Spiritling. Fletchling. Munna. Goomy. Litleo. Finneon. Ooh, nice. Reverse Gligar. And behind, regular rare Bronzong. Come on, the gods of electric. The Pokemon gods of electric. May Raichu bless you this packet with victory. So there we go, dudes. Undo debts. Remember, take one each. Right, we have ourselves versus Seeker. Sort this focus out a second. Yeah, Baldur. Onscope, Skarmory, Rock and Roller, Frillish, Venonat, Chansey, another reverse Purloin, and the very last pack of the Phantom Forces is a Pachisaru. Regular rare. Well, we didn't find the Mega Gengar EX, we didn't find whatever else, but we found some beauties, I tell you now. Right, as a recap, we're going to show you all the holos from this set. Oh, this, I'm going to do it side to side. So we've got a Girafarig, Spiritomb, Venomoth, Purloin. I'm not going to show them off too much like this, because you can go back and pause them and see them properly. Shauna, Gligar, Venonat, Trick Coin, Steel Shelter, Pyro Hollow, Swirlix Reverse with the Jelly Beans, Reverse Bronzor, Holo Lysander, Holo Rare Chandelure, Pyro Holo again, Lumineon Reverse, Purloin Reverse, Purloin Reverse, Carablast Reverse, Holo Versus Seeker, Reverse Holo Bronzor, Reverse Holo Lipard, Reverse Holo Litleo, Holo Gengar Spirit Link, Reverse Holo Heatran, Skarmory Reverse, Finneon Reverse, Loudred Reverse, and Alamomola Reverse. So that was all of the commons and uncommons and rares. Now we're going to go to the special pulls. And Heatran Holo Rare.
Hey!
And this guy. So, so much excitement and confusion. So, Diancie as well, reverse. Are we good to go now? Well, in the recap, for the very, very nice pulls out of these packs, we have the Headringer, Team Flare card, looking beautiful. We pulled the Lysander, full art trump card. Beautiful art, beautiful shine.
Looking cool as heck.
Yep. Then we have the Malamar Full Art EX. Looking evil. All of the ones with the gold lines on look beautiful.
They are just spectacular. I wonder how the GX cards will pop
them. Oh, I can't wait to see them in real life. So we have the Florges EX Full Art. Getting another beautiful card. We have ourselves an Aegislash EX. Looking cool. We have the main man of the set. Fortunately, we didn't find the Mega, but it's a good start. Gengar EX. He may be viable for a deck, but only until I've got a copy of him, because he's going in a binder. And that, guys, was your recap. Hope you enjoyed everything you just seen there, because that was quite a bit of hype at the start of that, wasn't it? It slowed down a bit towards the end. I'm saying overall, out of the overall 32 packs that we acquired, not a bad pulling session, not a bad pulling session at all.
No, I've had way worse before, and it's only rare that you get better than this. I think all the cards we pulled are pretty awesome. I love that red card.
And the full arts, they're just all great. So guys, keep your eyes peeled, first and foremostly for the CP4 box, which we're guaranteed an EX, a Mega, or a break in every single packet, which I can't wait for, I really cannot. And yeah, and the anniversary box and the CP2 box as well, those will be everything that's open next. Oh, and you can also see the breakpoint box in the background, that's going to be opened and showcased at some time as well. But I think we're going to do that after the Japanese boxes. So, yeah, one love PTs. Have a nice day.
Peace.